Hello students, welcome to this discussion on marine pollution. Marine pollution is defined as the discharge of waste substances into the sea, resulting in harm to living resources, hazards to human health, hindrance to fishery, and impairment of quality for use of seawater. So this marine pollution, whatever we pollute the sea and oceans, so it has got hazards on human health, hindrance to fisheries, impairment of quality for use of seawater and other living resources. Marine pollution is associated with the changes in physical, chemical and biological conditions of seawater. So pollution can be like physical pollution, like plastic, something you are throwing, unwanted materials. Chemical pollution, all these fertilizers, pesticides going inside, or biological, like algae, organic matter. The causes of marine pollution. The most obvious inputs of waste are through pipes directly discharging waste into the sea. So you might have seen a lot of industries, they have could put pipeline directly into the sea. Okay, the municipal solid waste goes and sewage from the residents and hotels in coastal towns are directly discharged into the sea. If you find industries, no, they discharge effluents into the sea directly, which are located in the coastal area, like Goa, Karwar, this Ankola, these are all coastal belt. No? So industries, municipalities, even residences, hotels, they discharge. Pesticides and fertilizers from agriculture, which are washed off the land by rain, enter water courses and eventually reach the sea. So this whatever fertilizers and pesticides people use due to monsoon, the rains, it will enter the water courses and it will go to the rivers and ultimately end up in the sea. Petroleum and oils washed off from the roads enter the sewage system. When storm water overflows, these materials are carried into rivers and eventually into the seas. Now the ship accidents which happen and accident spillage in the sea can be very damaging to the marine environment. You might have heard of that Exxon oil spill, huge oil spill was there, oil tanker. So the such things are regularly, even small tankers, they are not coming to the limelight. But they cause a lot of damage to the marine environment. They may contain heavy metals and other contaminants are often dumped out into the sea. Like heavy metals, we have seen lead, mercury and all, no? Cadmium. They are dangerous and they are sometimes dumped into the sea. Even offshore oil exploration, like Bombay High, in India we have got Bombay High, no? In the water. So that causes pollution to the seawater to a large extent. So what are the effects of marine pollution? Apart from causing eutrophication, a large amount of organic waste can also result in the development of red tides. This eutrophication reduces the quality of water basically. Many important commercially important marine species are also killed due to the clogging of gills or other substances. As we have discussed, a lot of these marine species, aquatic life, no, they get killed due to clogging of their gills. They breathe through gills, no, and these all material, physical materials will clog the gills. Oil slicks damage marine life to a large extent. Salt marshes, mangrove swamps are likely to trap oil and the plants which form the basis of these ecosystems, these suffer. So these salt marshes, mangroves, swamps and all are likely to trap oil and the plants which form the basis of these ecosystems, thus they suffer. So what are the control measures for marine pollution? Reducing the pollution load of marine waters is through the introduction of sewage treatment plants, This will reduce the biological oxygen demand of the final product before it is discharged to the receiving waters. So as we have discussed, biological oxygen demand means when there are organic matter in the water, and this bacteria which thrive and treat that, they consume lot of oxygen from the water. So the oxygen in the water gets reduced. So this is known as biological oxygen demand, which is required to oxidize the organic matter. So sewage treatment plants, like for our municipality waste, that sewage treatment plants are there, which take care of treatment of the water. So now the when comes to treatment, the primary treatment and secondary treatment. So primary treatment, these treatment plants use physical processes such as screening and sedimentation to remove pollutants that will settle, float, or that are too large to pass through a simple screening device. Very simple it is. See, now one is screening. Screening means now you are drinking tea sometimes. So what happens? The tea powder, you will screen it, so that tea powder doesn't enter your cup. That is physical screening. I told you about the bar screens in the ETP. In small house, we have got this filters, strainers. But in for this municipality use, they have got large steel screening, so that all the physical plastic bottles, this all unwanted material which is carried away by water, is screened. And then the second is sedimentation. Sedimentation is simple process. They have got big tanks. They'll allow the water to settle. So what happens? The heavy things, they'll settle down. All the heavy material in the water will settle down. This is known as sedimentation. Okay. And even as like when they allow the water to stand still in the large tanks, if any oil is there, that will float. Or any some small plastic materials are there, that will float. So that is skimmed out. That is taken from the surface itself. So this is primary treatment. After screening, the wastewater passes through a grit chamber. The detention time is chosen to be long enough to allow lighter organic matter to settle. Okay, so it passes through a grit chamber where the lighter organic matter is allowed to settle. From the grit chamber, the sewage passes into a primary settling tank, also known as sedimentation tank, where the flow speed is reduced sufficiently to allow most of the suspended solids to settle down by gravity. This sedimentation means you allow things to settle down by gravity. Okay. If the waste is to undergo only primary treatment, then it is then chlorinated to destroy bacteria and control odors which the effluent is released. Please understand, whatever this water is there, domestic sewage, the municipality sewage, it contains bacteria. So these are never released directly. They have to be chlorinated to kill the bacteria. Otherwise, they will cause lot of harm. Okay. If it is, this is in only primary treatment is used, but there are mostly there is secondary treatment also. So secondary treatment, the main objective of secondary treatment is to remove most of the BOD. So here we want to remove the BOD. And how to remove the BOD? There are three commonly used approaches. One is trickling filters, activity sludge process, and the oxidation ponds. We will see these three processes in detail. A trickling filter consists of a rotating drum, distributing arm that sprays liquid wastewater over a circular bed of fist-sized rocks or other coarse metal. The spaces between the rocks allow air to circulate easily so that aerobic conditions can be maintained. The individual rocks in the bed are covered with a layer of slime, which consists of bacteria, fungi, algae, etc., which degrade the waste trickling into the bed. So trickling filter means slowly it is getting down. So it has got rocks actually, like size of our fist. Okay, so that is distributed, and on this water is made to flow. So what happened? It is sprayed. So first spraying, what happens? The air will circulate in the fist side rocks, so that aerobic conditions are maintained, means air is available there. Okay, and this rocks are covered with, the rock bed is covered with slime, which consists of bacteria, fungi, algae, etc., which degrade the waste trickling into the bed. Any organic waste is there, then these things will take care. In the activated sludge process, the sewage is pumped into a large tank and mixed for several hours with bacteria-rich sludge and the air bubbles to facilitate degradation by microorganisms. The water then goes into the sedimentation tank where most of the microorganisms settle out as sludge. See, activated sludge means the sewage is pumped into a large tank and it is mixed with the bacteria-rich sludge and air bubbles to facilitate degradation by again this degradation of microorganisms means bacteria only. Okay, so these are bacteria, they will eat away the organic matter in that, and then this water will be going to the sedimentation tank where it will settle down and the microorganisms will settle down and they are again recycled. The oxidation ponds are large shallow pans approximately 1 to 2 meter deep where raw and partially treated water is decomposed by the organisms. Oxidation ponds means actually it is open to the air. Okay, they are not very deep, 1 or 2 meters deep only. So here the treated water is decomposed by the microorganisms, and even these oxidation ponds, there can be aeration also. They may spray the water also on the top so that the air, when it gets sprinkled onto the top, when it is falling down, it will take that oxygen from this water particles will take the oxygen from the air. Okay, and then what we have seen, oxidation means these microorganisms, they also decompose the partially treated sewage. See, please understand, now when we are discussing here, we are discussing that there is bacteria, fungi, algae, microorganisms and all. So these are also very important in this ecosystem, whatever this human man is living. So these are all important for human life. Okay, thank you.